Hello. I thought you'd want to be here today. I was most excited about coming back to find out about how Thimble's getting on. She's going on an adventure. How exciting. Let's delve in. It wasn't yet dawn, and Thimble was up deciding the best things to take with her on her travels. She'd had a bad night's sleep, partly because she was so excited about her impending journey, and partly because her mother, Lady Flute, had been pleading with her only daughter to reconsider everything and forget all the nonsense. And partly because finding Blossomberry, who could be absolutely anywhere by now, to be fair, was not going to be an easy task. Thimble had, of course, ignored her mother's pleading to reconsider and pointed out to her somewhat distraught mother that she absolutely and most definitely hated wearing dresses, and she would have to wear one every single day as a member of the royal household, which she quite simply could and would not put herself through. This, in turn, had made Lady Flute, who was a particularly marvellous seamstress, I have to say, burst into tears. Oh dear, dear, dear. Which made Thimble feel absolutely terrible. She then spent the rest of the evening promising her mother that she could make her a welcome home dress in as many frills as she liked if she gave Thimble her blessing. Eventually, it was Lord Flute who convinced his wife that stubborn Thimble was not going to change her mind. No. So at last she was given both parents' blessing on her plans to accept the Queen's quest. Thimble took several books down from her bookcase and lined them up in order of practicality. She had decided that she was about to venture into relatively unknown lands, and so she would have to side on the air of caution and choose a practical manual to take with her. And she chose a book on the ins and outs of plants around the different realms. She had absolutely no idea what to expect when she left the valley, or indeed where she should start, as she really hadn't been anywhere that far, and didn't really think that visiting Periwinkle in the Pixie Realm to sample his latest batch of parchment beer counted. Dear, dear, dear. The only things she was certain of were the butterflies that were now fluttering in her tummy, and they were willing her on with more excitement than she had ever felt. Lady Flute had wrapped up some food in a linen rag, which would last a few days. She also packed a small leather water bottle. As the morning sun softly rose, Thimble peered out of the front door of the Flute family home. She could see streams of colourful bunting and daisy chains hanging everywhere. Many of the fairies in the valley had been up all night preparing a very special send-off for the little brave Thimble. Everyone had been so captivated by the story of the little fairy sent out into the lands she had never been before to bring back the Queen's long-lost cousin, Blossom. There were claps and cheers as Thimble hugged her parents goodbye and made her way through the streets and lanes of her homeland. The apple orchard was filled with silver tinsel and pink bows in her honour, and all the bees swarmed to make a special sign of good luck in the shape of a shamrock for Thimble as she passed. As she approached the castle grounds, she could hear the trumpets' fanfare, and at the bottom of the huge palace gate, she could make out the tiny figures of Prunus and Myrtle waving flags and cheering every step she took with all the other knaves and courtiers. That was all except Till, of course, who was in the palace kitchens eating honey biscuits. Oh dear. Thimble's heart began to flutter with excitement and nerves at the prospect of what may lay ahead, and she almost wondered if what she was doing was the right thing, but soon put doubtful thoughts to the back of her mind when she remembered what it would mean if she stayed. Walking up the great castle steps, it seemed to Thimble as though she was making fairy history, which of course she was. I know, very proud. And she was absolutely sure that one day someone would write about her. Well, of course, I have. Queen Lilibell greeted the little fairy at the top of the steps outside the great front doors of the palace. She looked as excited as everyone else and was smiling, which she very rarely did, and this put the little fairy at ease. All the cheers from the crowd below stopped, falling silent for Her Majesty to speak. "Thimble, cotton flute, a brave fairy with a warrior's heart. You have accepted my challenge to track down and bring back my dear cousin Blossom Bowie in exchange for your proposed marriage to Till," said the Queen before taking a bite out of a biscuit she'd been keeping in her pocket. She swallowed and continued, "I wish you well, little fairy, and hope that this sword will protect you," said Lilybell as she took a small, perfectly formed sword from a cushion being held by one of the knaves. It was engraved with the royal coat of arms on both sides and its blades were made of pure silver. Lilybell gently handed it to Thimble. "I do hope you never have to really use it, Thimble," she whispered. Thimble curtsied and graciously accepted the Queen's gift. Now all that was left to do was for Thimble to set off on her journey. She curtsied to the Queen once more and turned and waved at the valley folk, who all cheered and clapped while chanting fairy songs about the brave, beautiful fairy folk of the Fair Valley. Then very slowly, Thimble turned and walked to the north gates of the royal gardens, which led from the valley towards the last standing dwelling oaks at the edge of the fairy realm, which led into the more pixie realm. Once far out of sight, Thimble sat down by the huge trees, took a deep breath and pulled out her wand. "Well, now it's just you and me, Twig. I will be honest, I have no idea where to begin. So I thought it would be a good idea to start with a visit to Periwinkle just over the hill in the more pixie realm, as he's always got lots of answers." And indeed, he did always have lots of answers, as his library was one of the biggest in the realm. And he had been a great scholar in pixie lore for many, many moons. So with that thought in mind, Thimble blasted her face with sparkles and stars before setting off to find her very best friend, Periwinkle. Thimble arrived at Periwinkle's door at about noontime in pixie timekeeping, where the time was counted slightly differently than in the fairy realm. Now, the Moor Pixie realm was neatly sandwiched somewhere between Moor Valley and the realms of the far north, and Thimble was a familiar visitor to the rocky terrain. She knocked on the old wooden door of Periwinkle's little cottage, with its two crooked chimneys, as loudly as she could and waited. But after a short wait and not hearing anything, she knocked again, and again, and yet again, and still no answer. Dear. She waited and knocked again, even louder, making a slate slide down the roof. But still no one came to the door, and there was no sign of anyone being at home at all. Oh dear. Thimble had had quite enough of waiting on such an important day of her life and had decided to open the door to see where Periwinkle was herself. And she didn't have to look far, as she soon found him fast asleep, tucked up in his little wooden box bed. "Periwinkle, pixie! What are you doing napping in the middle of the day?" exclaimed a baffled Thimble, who had half expected a welcome party. As she was sure the news of her quest must have travelled as far as the Flatlands, and the Moor Pixie realm was much nearer than that. Periwinkle gave out a big yawn and slowly opened one eye. "Ah, my brave fairy friend, Thimble. We had such a party in your honour last night that, oh, my head hurts." Thimble, a little disappointed to have missed the festivities, pulled him out of bed and put the little copper kettle used as a bookend on the stove to make nettle tea. "I need you with a sharp mind, Perry. You and I are going to plan my journey, and I fear it may take up valuable searching time," said Thimble, filling a cup with water and putting it in front of Periwinkle's half-awake face. "Searching time?" inquired the little pixie, and then fell backwards off his stool as he remembered. "Ah, yes! Goodness me, Blossom and the Queen, and you being the bravest fairy that has surely ever stuck up for herself.
Let me find a feather and scroll and we will set a plan in motion. No parchment beer until all is done. Maybe just one. And with that, Periwinkle scurried off into his library, leaving Thimble to ponder on just how brave she thought she really was. It was many hours before Periwinkle reappeared, clutching a pile of books, scrolls and a very dusty looking manuscript. Thimble had been reading through the book she had brought with her and was now wishing she'd brought a book with more pictures in. At last, she sighed, as a very dusty, dishevelled looking Periwinkle placed his findings on the table and opened maps and scrolls. This is going to be the most amazing adventure any fairy has ever been on, if you are successful, Thimble, gushed Perry excitedly. I almost wish I was able to come with you, but fear I am not brave enough, as your journey will take you through the blackened forest. Not a place any pixie would ever like to go. Thimble sat down next to him. The blackened forest? She inquired, not particularly liking the sound of it. Yes, but you've nothing to worry about, I'm sure, said Periwinkle, trying to skim over the subject. And indeed, Periwinkle had good reason not to alarm his fairy friend so soon into the proceedings, as the Blackened Forest was notorious for being one of the most frightening places to have to travel through, with tales of it being full of strange and mysterious creatures. And many a traveller have lost their path in the Blackened Forest, never to be seen again. Oh, dearie me. Quite. Periwinkle put the kettle on. The first thing we need to do, Thimble, is write down your journey in order of realms you will come across during your search. No rock must go unturned, no bush or tree unclimbed. So let us start immediately, said the pixie, opening a blank scroll and writing numbers down it, followed by the realms he had been reading up on in the library. The Blackened Forest, wrote Periwinkle studiously. Dangerous, unpredictable, and notoriously difficult to cross. Don't speak to spiders. Don't tread on toadstools. Goodness. The Elvian realm and whispering caves, he continued. A peaceful realm with hospitality so rich and welcoming, it is very hard to leave. Elves are always helpful. The opulent opals, he continued. Be careful of water holes and a sticky bowbell plant. The flatlands. Beware of trolls. They are very suspicious and will not believe you under any circumstances, so try to avoid them at all costs, Thimble. Perry also drew some rough sketches of the different lands and tried to include as many of the landmarks, lakes and rivers that had been documented in his vast collection of books. He then finally put down his feather pen and looked at his scribblings intently. This is your passage, Thimble. Are you brave enough to take the Queen's challenge and find Blossom? He asked excitedly. Thimble paused and then said in a very clear voice, I most certainly am, Perry, and I shall succeed, or at least I will do my very best. And she sat down to read her journey plan over a hot soup supper with her best friend Periwinkle. And they sang their favourite old drinking songs around the campfire before bed. Oh, these are the calling birds. I shall have to go. I know you shall want to come back next time. Find out what happens to Thimble on her travels. Wonder where she's going to go. I guess the Blackened Forest. Anyway, till then, take care. And remember, don't stop believing. Especially in you.